He's ready for love. Come on, everybody, sing with me now. Sorry about the helicopter, but spring cleaning is ready for love. Hello, you guys. Welcome back to the Golf Match. I'm so fucking excited. I did Friday's games picks for my picks for Friday games yesterday. If you guys listen to that, go check it out. Leave it somewhere here. I'll leave the annotation with my name, with my little subscribe button here. Name to click on to subscribe, and the video, like right here. So I'm excited. Spring games are back. Technically, spring games start today. If you want to get technical, today the Arizona Diamondbacks play. I'm saying minor league team versus Grand Canyon University. It's the only game today. If you want to count, spring games are back. But I really don't watch those, and they probably don't usually televise them anyways. And tomorrow is like Boston's team and Detroit and all them. They're playing like all these colleges. I think some team in Arizona is playing like Wisconsin and Florida Eastern and all these other teams, but don't care. But yesterday I called it opening night for spring ball, spring games. On Friday, except with the wind. It's a little windy. We have a big helicopter because we usually do police training around here. We have the stadium. We usually police drive their cars when they have to fly the helicopter around. But I usually call the Friday game spring opening night. Because you know when you watch opening night of just regular baseball, it's usually like one game or two games. It's usually one that team plays. Well, I'm going to call that one opening night because only like five games, okay? So Saturday I'm calling it spring training opening day for spring for the Grapefruit League and the Cactus League. For Florida and Arizona, because basically every team you can think of is playing that day. No one gets a break. No one gets to just train and go work out in the gym. Every person is playing Saturday. So let's kick it off. Are you guys excited? Let me know. Are you guys excited? I got my paper here and I'm ready to talk about it. I wrote everything down. Let's go, baby. Anyways, we got the Houston Astros kicking off in the Grapefruit League of Florida. Houston Astros at Detroit at Joker Marchman Stadium. I talked about it on Friday that I wrote all the team stadiums, and then come Saturday I wrote a little bit of team stadiums because it's just getting tired of writing all the team stadiums, so I just remember who's home and who's away, I'll tell you. Anyways, Detroit Tigers. Houston Astros is in my Angel division. I'm Angels right now because we're playing Saturday, so I'll be talking about it. But the Tigers are Astros. That's gonna be good. That's gonna be a decent one to watch, honestly, for Saturday opening day. And I think it's in Detroit because they're still trying to finish up the last finishing touches of the ballpark of the Palm Beaches for the Nationals and the Astros. Their new ballpark in West Palm Beach, Florida. It's called the Ballpark of Palm Beaches. And if you guys don't know by now, that Peoria Sports Complex, the Padres and all them, are getting a kids, play area for the kids. And also they're getting not the world's largest, but there's probably a bigger video board than regular settings. But in spring training, they're getting the world's largest video board for spring training. Like a HD, really high quality. The back of the day was like a shitty old board. All the other teams get like old boards. Some teams are getting new ballparks. Some teams are getting like updated locker rooms, dugout, clubhouses, all that for some spring teams. Like surprising us getting like new renovations and all this. But my stadium, Timberdale Stadium, is not really getting renovated. Besides, back in the day they integrated like buying new stuff in the clubhouse, probably and new cup holders to seats. But I feel like the seats at spring games are smaller than at regular. They get more living room. Spring games are kind of close up to each other. Like if you say thanks to somebody, you're like really close. But anyways, spring games. Here we go. So I'm gonna go with Detroit over Houston. Not because they're in my Angels division. It's just because the Astros, I haven't really heard anything about them coming out of the camp. I heard a little bit about Detroit, how Verlander's gonna do. I think he's gonna do great. But it's gonna be a tough run. Okay, the American League East, the National League East is probably one of the toughest divisions I think in the MLB today, to date. Anyways, we're gonna. So I talked about Friday that the that the Phillies are playing the Yankees at Yankee Stadium, I think, in Lakeland, Florida, at their stadium. But now the Yankees are playing the Phillies at Bright House Field. This is Grapefruit at Philly Stadium. If the Yankees are going to take one, do you think the Phillies are going to take one? Some people say the Phillies are looking good. They got rid of Howie Kendrick from the Dodgers. Now he's a Philly, I think, for like 2 years or a year. I guess we'll have to go with Phillies. I feel like I only get the Phillies this one. Besides, the Phillies got rid of Ben Revere to my Angels. And I feel like, who knows? Come on. Who knows, so. Who knows what's gonna happen? Who knows what's gonna happen? Doesn't look like I'm running. Getting some doggy bags anyway. But who knows what's gonna happen? But should I say Phillies? Should I say Philadelphia Phillies? I want to, then I don't want to. So what do I do? What do I do? To go Yankees to just get the lead on them 2-0, like beat them Friday, they beat them Saturday. Y'all think so? Alright, let's go Yankees. But for what you're gonna go on even the series and make it 1-1 Phillies Yankees, because they're gonna have a lot more games to play. They said there's 175 games. That's what I heard. 175 games will be shown on MLB Network, so that's a lot of games. So I'm gonna go with Yankees. Oh, when the Yanks, oh, when the Yanks, oh, when the Yanks come marching in. No, I'm gonna go for that. I'm gonna go Yankees. Let's not even it up. Let's go 2-0 Yanks. Ease. Anyways, I gotta get some doggy bags here. Sorry about that. My dog. Anyways, I'm fucking. Let me see. Okay, let me get my paper right here. Sorry. Can I, where did I leave off? Yankees. Okay, next. Cardinals, Marlins. At Roger Dean Stadium for the Marlins. I mean, it's kind of weird for the D-backs and the Marlins, the two teams that have basically on the stadium. They get me for spring games. They should play at their own stadium, honestly. I think they should do that, but no. They have to play at their respective spring ballparks where they train. Cardinals, Marlins, I don't really see any intention that the Marlins are going to do good this year, honestly. I haven't really heard anything coming out of their camp. We'll see what happens after Jose Fernandez. Gone. He died. R.I.P. Jose Fernandez. You had a young baseball career coming. He could have pitched forever in his baseball career. It was like in his 20s, I think, when he died. I hope they can come back after the loss of Jose Fernandez last year. You know, I hope they can kind of come back. See what happened. So, you know, it's tough to, you know, like the Royals, how the Royals are gonna do after they lost Ventura, you know. So it's gonna be a tough one to see for the Marlins and the Royals. But I heard like the Marlins are, I mean, the Royals might do good this year. Well, that's what we're hearing out of camp. Eric Hosmer might come back with the team, or he was on the free agent market or something like that. But I'm just gonna go with Cardinals, and I feel like, unless they're gonna do like a tribute on that opening day to Jose Fernandez, and maybe the Marlins might win, but I feel like the Cards might have it. They have some good players. They have some good players. So it's a good team. I don't know if the Cards are gonna do either this year, but I feel like the Cards are gonna probably take one over the Marlins. So I'm gonna go with Cards over Marlins. Marlinis. All my paper have all the way up to a couple games on Monday to start week 2. if I get a good response, like I said yesterday, if I get a good response, then I'll keep on doing my spring picks. So next we got the Blue Jays at Braves at Champion Stadium. Ooh, Blue Jays Braves. Ooh. They got Brandon Phillips. And they're getting a new stadium, and I think it's called, SunTrust, or SunTrust Stadium, something like that. Because their old stadium is at Turner Field, which they're giving to Georgia State College, Georgia State Panthers, to turn that stadium into a football stadium. So it'll be the Georgia State Panthers football stadium now, not the Braves. But I'm going to go with the Braves. I'm going to go with the Braves over the Jays. I want to see how Brandon Phillips does. I want to see how the team works with the new second baseman, Brandon Phillips. See how he does. The Jays are looking pretty good out of camp. Some people I've been hearing some rumors about, you know. Donaldson, they have some really great players. Some really decent, great stars. So I'm going to go. I want to say Blue Jays, but I want to see Braves. I want to see how Brandon Phillips is going to do. How some of the players on the Braves are going to do, you know, after losing some players or some players during the WBC, because I think some players might play maybe a game or two in spring, and then when they do, because WBC is in 2 weeks. So that means teams are going to probably be going to their spring, because I think USA Spring games are in Scottsdale, USA's training. So, those Jays. How about... Okay, next we have the Pirates at the Rays. Pirates over Rays. I feel like the Rays, nothing too surprising coming out of Rays camp. And the Rays they're okay team, they're not the best. Every year they're kind of just not. If they get some good talent, some good players, then maybe they might be a team that everybody will talk about. Or at least, so they might have a chance, at least win a couple games, you know. It's like, no one's really talking about the Rays too much. And when they do, they need some decent work for the Rays. Tampa Bay, and they're home too, so the two home teams, like the Marlins and Reds, should play at their own stands, but they're not going to, because they have to follow the MLB rules and play at their spring. And this one, the Rays home, the Rays are, let me see, I think the Rays are home on this one. So I have it all backwards here. The Rays are home. Wait. That's Friday, sorry about that. The way I'm looking at it, she's about to pull it out. But, they are home. Charlotte Sports Park. That's what their thing's called. Twins, Red Sox. Wait. The Twins went with that. South Park, Park South Fenway. So the mini version of the Green Monster, I like that. Like I said before, they do all these interpretations or redesigns of their spring training ballpark at the regular stadium ballpark. So the Green Monster, they reinterpret it at their stadium. So it's kind of cool to see that. Twins, Red Sox. I gotta go Red Sox. The way the Red Sox are looking this year with Chris Sale coming to the team, the addition of Chris Sale, it's something big and something pretty exciting to see. After him leaving Chicago, you know, it's the one to watch, and I'm excited to see it happen. So I'm gonna go to Red Sox. The Red Sox are gonna look. It's gonna be tough in the American League East to see the Red Sox and Yankees battle. I feel like it's gonna come down to the wire. That who's gonna take first? Who's gonna take second? So watch out for the Yankees. And the Red Sox, this year's baseball season is going to be one for the ages. I don't know if there'll be any controversy this year, but breaking news, you guys, I forgot to talk about this in the beginning of the video, that the rule changes are not going to be changed. The commissioner spoke about it yesterday. There won't be many major rule changes or anything like big rule changes. He made last week he made a press conference in Florida for spring. Now he made a press conference yesterday in Arizona for spring, and he said there's not going to be many rule changes. But today, we had one kind of rule change that some people are just heated about, pissed off about, is that there's not going to be the four-pitch walk, intentional walk. You know, this big guy, let's say I was pulled at the bat, and a man on the base, and this guy's the best, and smack a home run. They always want to walk the big guy, you know, or the big hitter, you know, and walk him to put him on base. But they're going to not do that anymore. Some people are heated, they're fired up. if you guys watch MLB Network, I watch one of my favorites now is High Heat with Mad Dog, Christopher Mad Dog Russo, and he's always, he was heated this morning. I don't know if he liked the rule or didn't like the rule, but he was heated this morning, if you guys saw it. It's probably just ending. It probably wrapped up soon. But, wow, I think MLB now's on, but hearing that, that was so that was coming out of the news today, that intentional walk, the four-pitch walk is gone. No more four-pitch walks. Intentional walks. People are heated about that. I don't know if you guys are heated about that. I think the strike zone might be different as well. They might be changing the strike zone. People might be heated about that. But the four-pitch intentional walk in the player stands, and then the catcher's right here, and he catches, putting out the swing, you know, that kind of thing. You guys know what I'm talking about. Okay, so Red Sox over Twins. Then we have Orioles at Pirates. So this is, I guess, maybe this might be the split squad here. Or the Pirates at Rays might be the split squad. One of the two is the split squad. I think the Pirates at Rays is probably going to be the split squad. And Orioles at Pirates. I want to see if the Orioles at Pirates is the split squad, then maybe I'll go Orioles. But if it's Pirates at home, not their split squad, then I'll go with Pirates. So I'm going to go Pirates over Orioles. I'm guessing it's not their split squad. I don't know. But I'm going to go Pirates over Orioles at McKinn Field, I think it's called. Come on. Then next, we have a couple more grapefruit action. We have one more grapefruit action here, and that is Nationals at Mets. The Astros and Nationals are not playing at home yet for like maybe 2-3 weeks because their stadium, like I said, the ballpark of Palm Beach's stadium is getting the final touches. So they're hoping to get ready in time for 2017 spring games. So they're not playing a couple games right now because of that. FYI. Nats or Mets? Let's go Nats. Let's go Mets. Who the heck knows? Because the Nats signed Matt Wieters, like I said. This guy was up in the air, up in the chop block. Come on, doggy. Up in the air. Up in chop block is who's gonna pick him up, you know, like. I think the Rays were intending to talking to this guy, like, oh, we're gonna get the Rays are gonna sign Matt Wieters. Like, he was up in the air as being talked as maybe they might pick him up. But the Nats picked him up for a 2-year deal with a 1 year to opt out his contract to go to some other team if he wants to get picked up by some other team like the Rays. Or whoever up available in arms to sign him. So that's one perspective you can see there. Anyways, I'm gonna go Mets over Nats. I don't know who's in pitching again. North in the guard has earned what's going on in the Mets camp. That the Mets are looking pretty great. Talk about this win, but now we're gonna go to Cactus League. Hold on. Can I see me? Come on. Okay, now we're gonna go to the Cactus League here. Okay, sorry about my whole camera. Can everyone get out of here? Cactus League. So we're Arizona, so sorry about all this. Okay, now you guys see me. I'm sorry about that. So let me look at this here. We're going Cactus League. We're in Arizona. There's a lot of games in Arizona. Every team is playing Saturday. I mean, every team. It doesn't matter if it's split squad. Whatever. Doesn't care. Every team's playing. That's because the Giants at Scottsdale Stadium. So the Giants are home this one. Cubs Giants. Great battle here. I heard a lot. That Kyle Schwarber. Joe Madden. Might let Kyle Schwarber be behind the plate. And people want to see that. He's been in outfield. You saw that. And the World Series and all that. But he might get the play. He always wanted to be catching. He might get to start in the. Get to be catcher in the back. So. That's something we can all watch for, right? So, yeah. I'm going to go with Cubs. Only because it's supposed to be the Giants. And we got Royal at Rangers at Surprise Stadium. And what is Royal at Rangers Surprise? So, I guess Rangers and Royals share the stadium, I guess? It looks like. Who is the Rangers? I heard a lot of great things out of the Rangers after they signed Mike Napoli to that 1-year deal. Man. after the loss of Ventura leaving the Royals. He's done for the Royals, but I want to see the Rangers. And I heard a lot of good things coming out of camp for the Rangers and with the signing of Mike Napoli. We'll see what happens with that. Okay. We have White Sox at Dodgers. Basically, who's the home team here? The Dodgers are. They both share the stadium. The White Sox and the Dodgers at Camelback Ranch in Glendale, Arizona. But I want to see the Dodgers are going to be in. I had a lot of good things. The Dodgers are going to be the top in the American League. No, National League West. They're going to be like the top dogs. Like, watch out for the Dodgers. Like, and I think who's going to sneak by me are the Giants or the Rockies. Those are the two teams. Tonight is 30 for 30. 30 for 30 days. And today they're with the Rockies. Yesterday with the Mariners. And Monday they were with the White Sox. So Monday was the White Sox. Yesterday was the Mariners. Today's the Rockies and Bud Black, the manager. And he was on high heat. Heard some great things coming out of Rockies camp. Watch out for the Rockies. They might be sneaking in the playoffs, but I don't think they will be a World Series team. But they're going to sneak into the playoffs in the National League West. Watch out for that. Let's see here. Okay. So down to the White Sox, and we have Indians. Reds and Indians. The Indians are the home team, but the Reds and the Indians both should stay in like Goodyear. Goodyear is like the first thing you enter when you come into Arizona. Like if you go to Arizona and you're driving in, you already see the sign Goodyear. So Goodyear is like the first part. If you come on the West Coast side, like my side, when I drove in Arizona to the spring games, first thing I saw was Goodyear. So Goodyear is like the first thing you see when you come into Arizona. And they both should stay in like Goodyear Park. I want to see Indians. Heard a lot of things. The Indians might make it back this year. Maybe the World Series or the playoffs. Looking pretty good, so we'll see. So I'm going to go Indians over Reds after the Reds lost Brandon Phillips to him to go to the Braves. Okay, this is what I'm talking about. Everybody's probably been waiting for a few Angel fans. The Milwaukee Brewers at Angels, at my Angels, at Tempe Diablo Stadium. What is it looking at Angels camp? What can we hear? And I haven't really heard nothing much, but there's no... They talk... Her talk, I was watching this one of these videos, talking to our man, our GM. Is there any talks about Mike Trout? Any calls about for Mike Trout? No calls for Mike Trout. I think Mike Trout's going to sit pretty and stay in Anaheim. I want to stay in Anaheim for a good while, you know. He has a good contract right now. There's no ifs, ands, or buts. They're going to trade him or get rid of him or anything like that. I heard rumors the Yankees want him. I heard the Dodgers want him. If he goes to the Dodgers or the Yankees, I'm not going to be happy. Last year at spring training, I got a Mike Trout shirt, and I'm going to burn it if he leaves. Trust me on that. I'll probably film it, too. Believe that. But I'm going to go with Angels over Brewers. I really heard nothing much out of Brewers game. No really surprising good players. But I feel like we have good players coming back. We have Pujols looking great after his foot injury, or whatever, leg injury. He's sitting pretty, coming back, looking well. He cracked a couple of good balls. Sorry about the win here. But I feel like we're going to have a decently good squad. We're not going to be the... I hope we can sneak in second place, maybe third. Because what I heard after 30 close 30 days in just the Mariners Park, the Mariners are looking pretty good. It's a really good Corey Seager. Right, third baseman for the Mariners. The Mariners are looking pretty good. They might take second or maybe third. So it'll be a better team, probably me, the Angels, and the Mariners, probably who's going to take second and then third. But we all know, I know they have the sign of Roger Davis and they have Matt Joyce. But the Oakland A's are sitting pretty at the bottom. I'm just letting you know right now. All you Oakland fans are like, no, they're not. They're going to have a good team. When I heard of the camp, the team looks great. Well, that's good for you, but they're gonna sit pretty at the bottom. So it might go like, if we don't know about the Astros, I haven't heard anything about the Astros yet. I won't trust my luck. But I think they're gonna go Oakland A's, Astros, maybe Angels, Mariners, then whoever takes second, maybe Angels, Mariners, and Rangers. Like, so it's like the Rangers are gonna take first this year again. The Rangers are looking pretty hot and pretty. We'll go Angels over Brewers. I don't know who's going to be starting, maybe Shoemaker. And Houston Street is coming back after last year. He looked great, felt phenomenal. He came back, lost a lot of weight, dropped a lot of LBs. And I feel like he's looking pretty great. There's still a lot of more games to talk about. I'm not done yet. But, yeah. So, Angels over Brewers, whoever's going to be pitching. And we have Garrett Richards coming back out of that injury. Shoemaker and Garrett Richards are coming back. I'm excited to see that. Two great pitchers we got. So next we have this team that they're both in the stadium. Rockies at D-backs. Ooh, if you were saying the D-backs are looking okay, but a lot of talk about the Rockies, and tonight's 30 for 30. 30 club 30 is with the Rockies on MLB tonight, 3 o'clock my time. That'll be 5 o'clock Central and 6 o'clock Eastern on Pacific. And they both just see him at Talking Stick at Salt River. I think it's in Scottsdale, Arizona. Talking Stick at Salt River Fields, something like that. I'm going Rockies over D-backs. I heard a lot about the D-backs. I heard a lot about the D-backs also, but I heard a lot about the Rockies looking great. Bud Black is the manager. He used to manage back in 2015. Until he got fired, he used to manage the Padres. He didn't look so good with the Padres, but he might look good with the Rockies. They got Tyler Chatwood. He's a pretty good pitcher. That's decently good hitting. So watch out for the Rockies this year. Trust me on that. I'm telling you right now. And that's Salt River Field. Yeah, Salt River Field. Okay. So we have one more game left. And tomorrow I'm talking about all the Sunday games. So we have the Cactus League final game here for opening day. We have the Mariners at Padres at Peoria. Peoria. What am I saying this right? Peoria. Okay, I'm not saying that right. Peoria Sports Complex. The Mariners and the Padres. Wait, is it Padres at home or Mariners at home? This is a game I can watch because I do live in San Diego, but I'm not a Padres fan, but they do. I know where the Padres is. Okay, Padres are home. So we get to finally see the new video board. The new one that's supposed to be the largest video board in spring training. Padres and the Mariners both share Peoria. Peoria Sports Complex. They're both share stadium. I'm going to go with Mariners over Padres. Nothing too surprising besides the sign of Jerry Weaver. But nothing too surprising. So I'm going to go with Padres. I'm going to go with Mariners over Padres. So that's all my picks for the Saturday games. Let me know who you're going to pick. If you like my picks, stick with them for spring. If you don't, tell me why. But these are all the Saturday games. I call them opening day because every team, doesn't matter if it's split squad or not, every team is playing. It's Sunday. Every team is playing Sunday. Have them right here. I mean, not a lot of teams are playing Sunday, really, but a lot of teams are playing Saturday. So anyways, who's excited? Baseball's back. Starting today, you guys are gonna watch Arizona Diamondbacks versus Grand Canyon University. But I'm not. Anyways, thank you guys for watching this video. Like this video, leave me a comment, subscribe for more, and I'll see you guys later. Baseball's back, baby! Yeah! Well, just